Welcome back to the Capitol Center here in Landover, Maryland. Gorilla Monsoon along with his lordship, Alfred Hayes. We take a look at the sneak, the thief in the night, the repo man. You know, congratulations in order, Alfred, to the producers of Primetime Wrestling for those exclusive satellite hookups with Razor Ramon and Macho Man Randy Savage.
Well, there was certainly a lot of enlightenment coming from those two statements by both those men. But isn't the world of electronics a wonderful thing nowadays?
How we can hit up? Certainly is. Oh, listen to this ovation for the former Intercontinental Champion, Bret the Hitman Hart.
He certainly has, and he's lost none of his luster, even though he's lost his Intercontinental title.
Well, he kept it in the family, though, Alfred.
Yes, you can say that for him, I suppose. You know, he's going to have a tough time here against Repo Man.
Repo Man, very unorthodox.
And this will give us a chance to see how Bret Hart is bearing up under the strain of not having that intercontinental thing, or whether he's become a free spirit. Let's see whether the responsibility of not holding that belt has affected him.
Well, the Repo Man cannot and will not be able to match skills and abilities with a man who has excellence of execution, Bret the Hitman Hart, but he has other devious things that he can do.
He certainly has. He's got some great tricks up his sleeve, and he brings them into play, too. This man really is a master of the devious.
Obviously, when Repo Man was a youngster, he was a fan of Zorro, Alfred.
He could have been, yes, you're right.
He has a Zorro look-alike mask on there.
Well, that's to mask his expression, but he doesn't mask that too well. Because
no, he doesn't. He's always laughing.
Yeah, he's laughing, and he's got something sneaky going on all the time. He certainly appears to know something we don't know anyway.
Oh, nice counter there by the Hitman. Repo Man always strikes me as being paranoid, Alfred. I don't know why, but I just get that feeling.
Well, he probably is. I mean, after all, everybody's always talking about him. He liked that, too. Look, I gave a little dance there. He very seldom stands completely upright, too. A little crouch. All those moves make him very deceptive.
I guess he learned that by sneaking up on cars and TV sets and things that weren't nailed down.
And I suppose you have to keep your head low in case you're spotted.
Yeah, especially if you're repoing something that's not supposed to be repoed.
Do you think he's done that?
Oh, no question. Handful of hair buys him a little time there. Look out. Shoulder block and a beauty by the Hitman. Down quickly in front, Repo, but... Oh, backslide coming up. Can he get him? No. Was not driving with the legs. Uncharacteristic of the Hitman.
Yes, but some really sweet moves the Hitman is making now, and he's showing Repo that he can pin him anytime he wishes, even if he can't get it for the three count. You know, it's very demoralizing when you keep having your shoulders put down on the canvas. I know.
I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it.
Even if you can lift them up, it doesn't matter. It's embarrassing to have your shoulders put down.
What's he apologizing for, Alfred?
I don't know. He said he didn't mean it. Maybe he used some foul language or something. Or maybe it's something he's done in the past.
Referee on his case. Got caught right in the middle of that move. Sneaky, but not sneaky quick, Alfred.
Not anywhere quick enough to deceive Hart. Bret Hart is so quick himself. That's one of his main armaments, his quickness.
Well, if you had 12 or 13 in your family, you'd be quick too. You wouldn't get any groceries.
All beating you to the table.
Understand from the Hitman himself that everything is back to normal in the family situation as far as the Harts are concerned. All fences have been mended, and there is serenity once more.
Yes, I'm so pleased about that because Bulldog, British Bulldog's wife, Diana, is Brett's sister, and she was torn between the two situations there. Her loyalties had to be divided, and yet now all that has been solved by Brett being such a gentleman about the whole affair. Extending the olive branch to his brother-in-law was a very, very courageous thing to do, quite honestly.
No question. Showed a lot of class.
He did indeed. Much dignity, a lot of class.
Question will always remain in my mind, had the tables been reversed, turned around, what would the
You mean what would the Bulldog, the British Bulldog, have done? Would he have been as gentlemanly as Hart?
Absolutely.
A lot of chivalry there by Hart, but I don't know if Davey Boy Smith is capable of that.
And we'll never know, will we?
We won't know.
Of course, I'd like to see another meeting of those two somewhere down the road.
Do you think that either family could take that again? All that stress they had to cope with?
Well,
I think it would be a little unfair for either of those men to place them in such a
spot. Understand that Stu Hart
game.
Went down in the basement and Bruce went up in the attic, and neither one of them came out of there until the match was over.
Well, that could be so, because they certainly weren't up to Wembley Stadium on that tremendous night of nights, that historic night. 80,000 plus people there. What a night that was. Electric. Absolutely incredible.
Feet in the ropes. Referee will have to break this one. Hitman right now being the recipient here as the recall man is starting to go. Ooh, did he get that corner hard?
Stay here, man.
Corner post moved about 3 inches.
No way.
Look at this now.
There we go.
What a precarious situation to be in.
Now he's vulnerable. Highly vulnerable here for Repo.
Going to work on the quadriceps. That gastric nemius taking a beating too.
What is that, Gorilla?
Gastric nemius is the longest muscle in the human body, Alfred. Starts up in the gluteus maximus area and goes down behind the quadriceps, behind your knee, and forms part of your calf.
Well, I know what the calf is.
Oh. Just remember, it's the longest muscle in the body.
Okay.
Anyone ever ask you?
Right.
You'll have the answer. Whoa! Hitman looking for an answer out there on the concrete to how to figure out the repo man who's sneaking. Look at this. I don't believe this guy.
I really do admire Repo Man because he has so many detractors, and yet he does so well. He really doesn't take any notice of them at all. He just sticks to the task in hand, and that is to beat his opponents the way he knows how to beat them.
Well, the weasel, Bobby DeBrain Heenan, really likes the Repo Man. I guess he thinks he can get a TV cheap or something like that.
I wouldn't think that. I'm sure he doesn't. That's illegal, isn't it?
Absolutely wrong. Nice side suplex delivered, but not enough to hold the Hitman down.
That was three.
Complaining to the referee about a short count or lazy count.
Yes, I think he's wrong there, though. I don't think that was three at all. I think this referee was right on the spot there.
Wasn't even close.
No.
Nice block of this suplex attempt by the Hitman. Oh, and a snap, one of his own. Came right down on that left hip. That'll take some of the starch out of him.
Yes, that was a nice suplex there by Hart. He twisted him in midair and brought him down on his hip. And he's trying to go.
Inverted atomic drop delivered by the Hitman. And now a nice clothesline. Not going to get it. You're not going to beat a big guy like Repo Man with that kind of a cover.
He's got a lot of power, Repo Man. Bret Hart really pressing home his attack. He's had three excellent attempts to pin him, and this could be a fourth that could be victorious.
Ah, gosh. Shot that right arm out of there.
Wow, how close can you get there?
Oh, look at that nice move. Over the back goes Repo, but Bret holds on to that top rope.
He's a little bit tired at the moment.
Small package. Oh, and the Hitman rolls it up with a nice